Hello, welcome to Mock Question Monday. This week we're talking about verbal behavior, specifically the intraverbal. So first off, if you didn't see the hint in the scenario, take a look right now and see where it says elementary verbal operant. Right off the bat, that should have alerted you to the fact that there's only one option in the whole scenario that is an elementary verbal operant, and that is the intraverbal. Autoclitic is secondary, and the codic and duplic came a little bit later as categories for verbal behavior. In any event, if that didn't, that wasn't a hint for you, then let's talk about what intraverbal is and how you could have gotten this correct otherwise. The most important piece is that the intraverbal behavior is controlled by a verbal SD. That verbal SD cannot have point-to-point correspondence with the actual intraverbal response. So what does that look like? Well, most importantly, let's just say I ask 10 people, what's your name? So what's your name is the verbal SD. The response, which would be the intraverbal, which would be everybody's name, would not be the same for every single person. Versus if I held up an apple and I said, what is it? Everybody would hopefully say apple. So in the intraverbal world, everybody has their own response to any particular verbal SD, whether it's what's your name, what did you do today, whether it's the free association that we can experience together, or of course, there is a little bit of a limitation if the intraverbal behavior is a fill-in. So old McDonald had a farm sort of limits us. However, it does not have point-to-point correspondence. Old McDonald had a does not match the response farm. And that essentially defines the intraverbal. What is interesting about the intraverbal is the formal similarity piece, right? So the verbal SD and the response product do not have to have formal similarity. They can, right? We can have a verbal SD that's spoken and an intraverbal response that's spoken, or we can have a verbal SD that's written and a response that's spoken, or vice versa. There can be sign language. That piece is not as specific or important. It can vary. Now, really quickly, I'd like to talk about the other options. So codic and duplic are not elementary verbal operants. They came a little bit later, brought to us by Jack Michael. These are sort of umbrella terms for other verbal operants, not even just the elementary verbal operants. What's important in codic is that the verbal SD and the response do have point-to-point correspondence, but not formal similarity. For the duplic, both are important. They must have point-to-point correspondence and they must have formal similarity. And autoclitic, that's just verbal behavior about one's verbal behavior. So anytime you add language to what you're saying to make it more obvious for your listener what your intention is, what you mean, what you're trying to get across, disclaimers, anything that you want your listener to know about why you are talking, that would be considered autoclitic behavior. I hope that helps, guys, and I'll see you next time.